Hello, my name is Mike, and today I want to show you how to calculate discounts when collecting payments. We've released quite a few videos recently showing you how to collect payments with Stripe using various payment methods. But we've had some questions about how to calculate discounts using our form builder, so let's get started. To make things easier to visualize, I have a form that's pretty much skipped ahead to the end. I'll start here with the subtotal. In your form, this subtotal field will probably be the value of a few fields added together, like this, and then checked as a read-only field so your users can't change it. Again, I'm just trying to make it easier to visualize, so I won't do that here. I will add another number field I'll call total, and make this one read-only though. This is where we're going to put our calculation. Now, while we pride ourselves on being a low-code solution, making a calculation requires something close to code that some people call math. Terrible, but we'll have to do it. In my first example, let's pretend I don't want to charge for shipping if the order is over $50. So really less of a discount and more of a non-surcharge. First, let's add a hidden field that we'll call shipping. Under advanced, we'll make its default value $7.95. Okay. Now, in our total field, we're going to have to make a calculation. Under default value, click the calculator. Now it's time for some almost code math. We want something to happen if the subtotal is 50 or more, and something else to happen if it's less than 50. So let's put some parentheses. If our subtotal field, which if we mouse over, we can see has a field ID of 19, so we'll type 19 inside brackets, is less than 50, we want something to happen. Great, so we have that part. Now, what we're going to do is type a question mark. This may seem weird, but this lets Formidable know that you want something to happen if this statement is true. So, in the true area, we'll put some parentheses again, and say that we want the subtotal field and the shipping field to be added together. And then we'll type a colon, because after the colon is what you want to happen if the statement is false. We'll just put the subtotal field. Because if it's true that the subtotal is less than 50, we need to add shipping. But if not, the subtotal is the final price. All right, let's update to save and check it out to make sure it works. And it does. 49 adds the shipping, 50 does not. Okay, before we go, let's try an even harder one. Instead of a subtotal, let's say you're a wholesaler and you sell hundreds of products at a time with price breaks. We can get rid of the hidden shipping field. We're not worried about that for now. Let's say $1 per item for over 1,000 items, $2 per item for 501 to 1,000, and $4 for less than that. What does our calculation look like? Get ready for some slightly confusing, almost code math. Let's start with the over 1,000. So in our parentheses, we'll ask if our field ID 19, which is now items, is greater than 1,000. Question mark, because if it's true, it's our items times $1, or just our items field ID. Now colon, if it's false, we need to check something again. If our items are greater than 500, then it's question mark $2 times our item's field ID. And then a colon, because if it's false, which means it's 500 or less, it's 4 times our item's field ID. So, is the number of items greater than 1,000? If yes, the total is the number of items because they're $1 each. If not, then is the number of items greater than 500? If yes, then it's 2 times the number of items because they're $2 each. And if not, then it's 4 times the number of items because they're $4 each. Let's hit update to save and check this out. And it looks like it works. The price changes depending on the total number of items with our price break calculation. And that's how easy it is to calculate discounts and prices using Formidable Forms. Subscribe for more WordPress and low-code application building tips, and I'll see you next time.